I don't think I need to explain barcodes or QR codes, so let me just show you how to create a barcode scanner in .NET MAUI, but in this video, I will cheat a little bit. Even though they're very, very old, barcodes at least, and QR codes are still very much part of our daily lives, I would almost say. Especially QR codes, you can see them on a screen or on some kind of poster or whatnot. You just point your device at it, it will detect it automatically nowadays, and it will transport you to some kind of URL on the internet, right? So you don't have to type out that whole thing manually, which is really cool. They're not the most pretty thing to look at, I'll admit that, but you know, it does the trick. And with barcodes, they're still on our every product, right? You go out to a store, it just goes bleep bleep, and you have to pay a lot of money, and then boom, you have this product, but they are still on every product. It's still used widely. And that also shows because the kind of question that I almost get asked the most when people want to transition from Xamarin or Xamarin Forms to .NET MAUI is there a QR and barcode scanner? And the good news as of now is yes, there is. It's actually the same ZXing or Zebra Crossing library that was available for Xamarin, Xamarin Forms that's now in progress of transitioning to .NET MAUI. So it's still a preview version right now. That's also where the cheating bit comes in a little bit, so make sure that you watch the whole video to know what that's all about. But that library has now been ported to .NET MAUI. And I hear a couple of people thinking now like, ooh, but that plugin, I used it because it kind of was the only one around, but it was kind of slow, right? It didn't focus that good. But that, from my first tests, shows that it's completely gone. This is a version that is written from the ground up. It uses new APIs on the platforms, and it is super fast. So let's just not delay any further and have a look how to use it today. So I've started Visual Studio 2022, and let's get to some coding. I've created a file new .NET MAUI application. You can see that on the left, open in Visual Studio. On the right, I have the mirror of my actual physical Android device right here, because scanning barcodes can be done at best with a physical camera that is only available on a physical Android device, or iOS, of course. So I've got that hooked up so that we can actually see some barcode scanning in action in a little bit. Now, I've mentioned iOS. This works for iOS. I've tested macOS. It works on that as well. It's probably best if you hold up the barcode to the camera of your MacBook and not the MacBook up to your QR code, but that's totally up to you. I think for Windows, it's being implemented right now, so I don't think it works at the time of recording. But there's also the barcode generation, and I think that works for all platforms. Now, let's get to it. So I've installed the NuGet package already, but let me quickly walk you through what to look for there. Go to your Solution Explorer, right-click on the project and say Manage NuGet Packages, and you want to search for zxing.net.maui. You can see I already searched for it. Make sure to check the Include Pre-Releases checkbox right here, and here you can see the zxing.net.maui. There's a couple of identifiers that look very similar. Leave those behind. You want the zxing.net.maui. At the time of recording, 0.1.0 preview 5 is the version. Install that and we're mostly good to go. We need to do two more things. An initialization line in our MAUI application. So let's go to our MAUI program right here, and we have our used MAUI app, and here we now need to add a little line, use barcode reader. And whenever we do that, whenever we use the IntelliSense suggestion, it will add the using zxing.net.maui automatically on the top. If it doesn't do that, please add it yourself. Now you see these green squigglies come up here, which will happen throughout this demo. Don't worry about it. This is something that needs to be fixed on the library side. It has to do something. It tells you like this is not supported on Android, whatever the target versions. It should mostly work. This needs to be fixed on the library side. So whenever there's new versions coming out, this should be fixed. But for now, we're done here. And the other thing we need to do is get the camera permission. So the permissions are requested automatically by the ZXing plugin, but we still need to add the metadata to our applications to actually request it, right? So we're running on Android now. Let me show you how to do it on Android. For iOS, I'll make sure that it's in the info plist for iOS and macOS. So the sample repository code can be found in the video description. You can find it there. I'm not going to walk you through all of that here in the video. Let's go to our platforms folder, our Android folder, and then find your Android manifest. For iOS and Mac Catalyst, it's this info plist. And here, there's no graphical editor ready in Visual Studio yet. So let me just copy this little XML thing here and change this internet into camera. And now we're ready to request the camera permission. So we've got all of that set up. Time to set up our UI. UI. Now, I'm going to reuse a little bit of the sample UI here. You can create all kinds of other crazy UIs. Let me know if that's something that you're interested in down in the comments, and I'll be sure to make a video. You can do overlays and all that kind of stuff. But for now, it's really, really simple. We're just going to add this one view, which is going to preview the camera, and with that, you can scan barcodes. So let me get this image out of the way, and I'm going to, well, actually, let's do this first. I want to import this XML namespace here. So XML NSZXing, that's what I'm calling it. Can be anything you want, but I'm calling it ZXing. And here I'm going to use IntelliSense to also search for ZXing, and you want to select the ZXing.net.maui.controls. So whenever we got that, we can access all the controls that are in there. Now let me get rid of this image, and I'm going to say ZXing, and I can see the barcode generator view, which is going to be another video. Let me know down in the comments if you're interested. The camera barcode reader view, that's the one we want, and a more generic camera view, which is used under the hood, so we're not going to worry with that for now. So this barcode reader view, and that's basically all that we need. Boom, we can now scan barcodes. Well, okay, there's a little bit more to it. I'll show you that. There is a couple of properties that we can use to influence the behavior. One of them is detecting. So you basically want to toggle that to the camera preview will still show up, but this will say if the event for detecting barcodes is fired, yes or no, basically. The detecting can be quite aggressive. It detects in every frame if there is barcodes. So if you have a scenario inside of your app where you don't want to detect, where you pause for a little bit, then set this to false. It's a bindable property, but for now we're going to set it to true. The other thing is torch enabled, so is torch on. So we have this little flashlight here, right, that we can set to on. It will show continuously and you will have a little bit more light to scan your barcodes. Let's set it to false for now. And of course, we have this little event for barcodes detected. So at the time of recording, there's only this event. Hopefully, there will be a command so that you can enable this also for your MVVM scenarios, or you can use the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit where we have the event to command behavior to hook this up and use it inside of your MVVM pattern. But for now, I'm just going to use this event. And here, let me give this label a name so we can actually, you know, show this in a little label right here that we can catch the value of the QR code that we're going to scan and see what it actually says. So barcode results, let's put that in here. And actually, let's give this barcode reader a little name as well, X name, because I'm going to use that for something else right here, X name barcode reader. Okay, so we got that set up. Let's give this a little width and height actually. So that, you know, it shows up. I think it gets a width and height automatically, and you can do all kinds of other layout things, of course, but now I just know that it will show up. So we got that. Now let's go to our code behind, so our mainpage.xaml.cs, and we should have this generated event right here. Now what I can do is say barcode result.text, which is our label, and I can set that to e.results. And this is multiple, right? So you can scan multiple barcodes in one go, basically. I'm going to focus on one for now, but you can detect multiple inside of your preview thingy. So I'm just going to select this first one. So this is a collection. And then you can inspect from one result, one barcode, the value, the raw, so that's the raw data, points of interest, the format that it detected, is it a QR code, EAN13, and we have some metadata here. So there's all kinds of properties that you can work with. Typically, you're probably interested in the value, that's just the thing that's inside of your barcode. And this all comes from the barcode detection event arc, so that holds all the information about the scan that just happened. So whenever you do this, the barcode scanning happens on a background thread, and whenever you want to update the UI, you need to do that on the main thread, else it will crash. So for examine forms, you need to do that with device.beginInvoke on main thread. Here we have the dispatcher.dispatch. You can also do isDispatchRequired to first check if it's actually required, but I know it is, so I'm just going to implement it this way. Let me do it like this, and boom. Okay, so now it dispatches and it goes on our main thread and it doesn't crash. So that is basically what we want to do here. Let's add the format here as well, so we have a little bit more data to work with. Little string interpolation like that, another e.results 0.format. So now we see the value and the format of the QR code. Now, before we actually go inspect if this works, let me show you the other thing why I give a little reference to the barcode reader element. So we have this barcode reader.options. And if you've been working with this plugin on examine forms, we had this options with a couple of more options, right? That makes sense. Is new, barcode reader options. So in here, we have a couple of properties, which is, let me show it up here in the IntelliSense, hopefully. Visual Studio, work with me, please. Here we go. So the auto-rotate, and auto-rotate, I think if you are, you know, holding your phone upside down against a barcode, it will try to rotate it and still get the value. The formats, you can say which formats it should actually scan, it should actually act on. So if you only want to scan QR code, set it to QR, and it will only detect the QR code, so you know you don't get any other data in there. Multiple, so you can do multiple from the same kind of like preview that's inside of the camera. You will get multiple results. That's why we had that results collection. You have to adapt your code to loop through the different results. And the try harder is a bit of a funny one. So the Zxing library is something that is a third party, basically, and that property comes from them. And I think it does some extra magic to actually detect, it tries harder to detect the barcodes. So if you want to make sure what that is all about, check the documentation. But what I wanted to extra show you is the formats here. So we have all these formats, and you can just set one format here. So code 39, code 93, EAN, QR code, and it will just pick up on that. And this comes from the barcode format enum, but we also have a barcode format S, so format, which has a couple of grouped ones. So we also can set all, which detects all barcodes. I think that's the default. We can do two-dimensional, so they're grouped with two-dimensional barcode types, and one-dimensional so that it will only pick up on those. So that's basically what you can do. You can totally also set this from XAML if that's what you want, but I just wanted to show you this little bit as well. Now, let me just deploy this to our physical device, and we're going to see our actual application show up here, and we can actually start scanning barcodes. So here we are, the application is being deployed. Let me pick up my actual physical device here and point it at something not embarrassing here on my desk. So here we are. If you're running this for the first time, I've been trying out this demo, you would see like the camera permission pop up here, but I've already accepted that. So here we have this little thing. The hello world is overlapping here, the label, which is kind of not great because now you can't really read what's in there probably, but let's see if it actually works. So I'm going to point it at this QR code that I've got here, and boom, you can see it says, don't forget to subscribe, which is pretty amazing. And it says format QR code. So I don't know what you want to subscribe to, but this is your reminder to do it. And that is kind of like how to implement barcode scanning in .NET MAUI. But before I let you go, I cheated a little bit, right? So I need to explain a little bit about that as well. Let me just stop this right here so I don't have to point this camera all the time. I cheated a little bit because the plugin is a preview, right? So there's a couple of bugs. There's basically two blockers that I run into. One, we have a workaround for, the other one not. But the good news is for both of them, we have a PR open, so it should be included in the next preview. Now let's go back to our MAUI program. And if you look closely, I had this little hidden region here. So what this does is configure handlers. This is something from .NET MAUI. And I manually added the handlers for this little plugin to this .NET MAUI application. Because there is a little bug in there. And because of that, it seemed to all just work. But whenever you pointed your camera at a QR code, it would do nothing. So this is the workaround. I'll make sure to put that in the code repository that's linked in the video description. There is a PR open to fix this inside of the package. The other thing is the one-dimensional, so just little bars, the one-dimensional barcodes could not be scanned if you did not put your phone in landscape. It would only do it in landscape. It would not do it in portrait. Now, I did a little debugging and I found out what the cause is, so I opened a PR for that. There is unfortunately not a workaround for that right now, so you're going to have to wait for the next release of the package. The good news is it works for QR codes. It works for 2D barcode formats, so just test it with a QR code for now. If you know that that works, then all the plumbing has been set up. You know that it will work in your code as well with 1D barcodes if that's what you need. But you'll have to wait until it's merged and for the next update. So yeah, that's how to work with barcode scanning in .NET MAUI. I'm sorry. I hope you can forgive me for cheating a little bit. At least I came clean, right? I told you what it's all about. So this is how to get started with barcode scanning in .NET MAUI. I hope this benefits you, and now you can transform all your Xamarin Forms applications to .NET MAUI, because now also this plugin has been made available for .NET MAUI, and you can use it to scan your barcodes. So right now I've tested this for iOS, macOS, Android. I think Windows is not quite there yet, so make sure to follow me on the socials so that I will tweet out whenever the new version is available and you will pick up on that and you can start testing the new things that are in there. Make sure to like this video if you've actually liked it so that it spreads to more people and more people will know to now upgrade their .NET MAUI application with this wonderful barcode scanner. If you're interested in generating also barcodes with this same package, make sure to check out this video, or if you just want to see some other .NET MAUI content, make sure to check out this playlist and click this button to see if you're subscribed, and I'll see you for the next one.